Friday, February 5th, with the Campbellton Tigers in Berwick at the Kings Mutual Century Center taking on the Valley Wildcats. Early on in period number one, puck comes to Grant Janes in front. He scores for the Wildcats just 5 minutes in on the power play, and the Wildcats take an early 1-0 lead over the Tigers on the first goal to Grant Janes. Now they haven't finished announcing that goal to Janes yet, and Campbellton's back in the other way. Comes out into the slot, and Eddie Banville is there. Dangerous guy to have with that much space in front of the goal. Banville ties it up. We're 1-1. Less than a minute after that, here come the Tigers again on the 3-on-2 across to Lorette. Fires! Just beats the goaltender, blocker side. Lorette puts the Tigers in front. It's now 2-1 for Campbellton. A little bit later in the period, Wildcats now on the attack again at the other end of the ice. Working his way out from the side, backhand shot. It's Grant Janes. He's got his second of the period. Wildcats have 2 goals. Janes has 2 goals. And it is 2-2 after one. Now early in period number 2, just over 2 minutes in, and the Tigers on the attack again. Shot through, and then the rebound knocked in by Gregor McLeod. McLeod has his first, and the Tigers go back in front by a score of 3-2, just 2.5 minutes into the second period. And that goal from McLeod is going to be the straw that breaks the camel's back. We're going to get a goaltending change. Kyle Aliverti's night is done at this point. 3 goals on 12 shots against. And Ryan Hustis will come in to play goal the rest of the way. Never easy to come off the bench like that cold, but Hustis comes out early in the second period. Let's jump to the third period now. Early seconds. Wildcats on the attack. This comes back to the point. Big shot by Nocella, but Janes is there for the rebound, and he tucks it in. 3 goals for the Valley Wildcats. 3 goals for Grant Janes. He's got the hat trick. And early in period three, the Wildcats have tied the game. 3 apiece. A little later in the period, Tigers working the power play, trying to get the puck out in front of the goal. It'll be blocked in front, but comes all the way to the back, and Benedict fires it in from the point. That one gets through everybody, through traffic, and into the back of the goal. The Valley native has got his team in front, 4-3 Tigers lead. Net is empty, final seconds of the game now. Toward the net, Janes is parked at the side of the crease, but he can't get a stick to that one. He'll fight for it in the corner. Comes to Brett McNeil of the Wildcats, gets around a defender. Again to Janes at the side of the goal, but he can't jam it home. And the Tigers will hold on, and they escape with a 4-3 victory at the Kings Mutual Century Center in Berwick. The Tigers had shut out the Crushers the night before in New Glasgow. They beat the Wildcats here, and they would go on to beat Truro the next night, completing the clean sweep through Nova Scotia.
A 4-3 loss for the Valley Wildcats tonight against the Campbellton Tigers on home ice. I'm standing by with Grant Janes. Grant, I always like to focus on the positive more so than the negative. You had a hat trick tonight. That's always got to feel good.
Yeah, my line was playing really well tonight, getting lots of chances. Linemates are feeding me puck every chance they get, and then I had a couple of good bounces off the boards for one of them there, and we were just working hard the entire game, and Juicy, also Nozella down there, fired one off the boards and came back up, and I got the rebound, so it's nice to get good bounces like that, but when we're working hard, we were playing well together, so.
And yeah. Since things have been changed around a little bit in this lineup, Butterworth is out, still recovering from surgery, you've had to add other guys step up and kind of replace that offense, and you've put a lot of pucks in the net over the last couple of games. You seem to have taken it upon yourself to try and fill that role.
Yeah, exactly. We got lots of guys out, and we're getting near the end of the season here, so all the boys really got to step up and improve their game, and I'm just trying my best to do my part and see how we can go finish off the season here.
A tough one tonight against Campbellton. The last time you guys played, it was a 1-goal game. You came out on the right side. This time, 1-goal game, you came out on the wrong side. Are there positives you can take away from tonight's game going forward?
Definitely. I think we were playing well as a team. Most of the lines are playing well together, and we were getting quite a bit of shots on net. Obviously, we'd like to get a little bit more and pound some of those rebounds in. But we didn't play bad for the most part. The boys are working hard, and hopefully next time we can come out on top.
And finally, this is the first of 3 in 3 nights. You've got divisional games coming up, Amherst, South Shore. What do you have to do to be successful there?
All the boys are just really going to step up. 2 big games. We need these points going forward. So all the boys got to step up, play the game we can. Lots of pucks to net, and lay the body and just play the way we can.
All right. Thanks very much. That's Grant Janes of the Valley Wildcats after a 4-3 loss at the hands of the Campbellton Tigers here tonight in Berwick.